Hi, I'm Lance Piggott. I am the founder of co-founder of Vintage Roots, and we started back in the mid-80s importing and distributing organic wines. The reason for this was we wanted to be self-employed, we had a passion for the environment, and we believed that organic was really the way forward and is the future for wine production, because it produces better quality grapes and therefore better quality wine. Why organic, everybody asked me. Well, I believe that organic must be the way forward. Spraying chemicals onto the land for our food production is not sustainable, as we now know, and it causes major health problems for not only us, but also all the animals in the environment. So we must be there to try and protect the environment going forward, especially as the world gets more overpopulated. And it's just been seen, even in France, that chemicals cause major problems in the vineyards. It's one of the second, I think, or third biggest sprayed crops in France is grapes. And these grapes are destined to go into your wine, which then end up in you. Now they're now banning pesticides around schools in Bordeaux. So if they're doing that, then you should think about the wider environment everywhere else. So why aren't they banning pesticides full stop? We don't need them, especially in the world of wine, because vines are strong enough to look after themselves, and if they're given the right maintenance and help, they will flourish. We're often asked, does organic wine give you a headache or a hangover? It depends on you, but generally they don't have such a negative effect on you, because the levels of sulfur dioxide in organic wine is much lower than in conventional wines. Now, people may not think that's a big deal, but it is quite a big deal. Sulfur is in all our food products, actually, and the less we consume, the better. There are a lot of wines now made in the organic world which are now made without the use of sulfur, so there's no addition of sulfur made at all. But in most certified organic wines, the sulfur levels are half what they are in conventional wines. So the producers are trying to cut this down to a reasonable level to keep the wine stable and still fruity and nice to drink. But actually more and more consumers are looking for wines with low sulfur content, and increasingly we are selling a lot more wines with lower or no sulfur added to them. Everybody asks me what's my favourite wine. I don't have a favourite wine, I enjoy wine. And I think the beauty of wine is you're not always drinking the same wine every day or every week, like you might do with a packet of pasta, you might eat the same brand. But with wine you generally change and you drink different wines. The world of wine is there to be investigated and enjoyed, and all the different grape varieties bring different pleasures to you at different times with different foods. I started working with Abel & Cole. Vintage Roots started with Abel & Cole about 10 years ago, I believe, and I value the partnership very great. They're keen to expand their range, make more people aware of organic wines, and it's something I want to be involved with and support, and try and bring our wines to the customers of Abel & Cole. Thank you.